A new study led by a nonprofit journalism group found that more than 90% of several top brands of bottled water were hugely contaminated with these tiny pieces of plastic particles that can create lingering health problems for people. So, no surprise, as I looked at this story, I said, you know, without even reading, I said, let me guess, Nestle's is involved. Yeah, well, here's the point. What it is, it's little strips of plastic that you can't even see. You have to, they do these tests with the process of a dye. And when you show the dye, you use the dye, you put it under a special light, all of a sudden you do a count.
Lights up.
You do a particle count, and the entire bottle is filled with these little pieces of plastic that move through your system. It's a system, and biologically, it becomes part of your system. And some people are able to, some people are able to deal with that other than others aren't. You have people with Crohn's disease, you have people with irritable bowel syndrome, and they have all types of gastrointestinal problems. They can't deal with this quite as well. So here's what I found incredible. Nestle's, when they tested Nestle's Pure Life, they did the test.
The name kind of jumps out at you.
The name of it is Nestle's Pure Life. Well, let me tell you what. Nestle's Pure Life had 10,390 particles per liter of plastic shards in there, or pieces of plastic in their drink.
To put that in perspective, San Pellegrino was on the opposite end of the spectrum.
Who was it?
San Pellegrino.
Okay. Italian company.
Yep, with 74. So 70, not 7,400, 74, and that Nestle had 10,000 and some change. That puts it all in perspective.
Okay, so you need to know this. You need to know Nestle Pure Life. If you want a lot of plastic in your system, and if your system will handle it, the problem is if you have GI tract problems, this really isn't a good thing.
But you can drink the water out of the tap. You can drink the water out of the tap and you think, you know what, I'm going to take care of my family. I'm going to drink more pure water. I'm going to get something that's nice and clean. There's going to be no contaminants in it. And here you are feeding your kids or your loved ones, and you're feeding them a bottle of water, Pure Life, with 10,000 different particulates in it.
10,390
particles. Pure Life. And you've spent money on it, and you could have gotten it for free.
You want it because it's going to be better
for
you, right? That's
infuriating.
Okay, here's the real stinger here. Okay, so Nestle finds out that the independent testing took place and that they found 10,390 shreds or little particles of plastic in this drinking water called Nestle Pure Life. Now, Nestle says, okay, we're going to do our own study. You know what?
Oh,
I can't make it up. What does Nestle say?
That they have no problems. It was biological
it was zero.
Pieces. It was, yeah, it was
zero.
All.
They said, we have zero. And that's, in other words, it's 10,000 versus zero. We see this all the time in practice in law because right now I'm handling the Monsanto Roundup case. And there's cases of cancer all over the world. I mean, the cases of cancer, leukemia, blood cancers of all kinds, neurological issues, birth defects. But when
you've got a name for the people that they get hired by the industry.
Bioestatutes.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, they go out and hire bioestatutes. And the bioestatute is somebody that can hire at a university. And
they'll
the
say anything for
yeah, for you pay them enough money. Oh, no. There's
zero particulates in Nestle
yeah,
Pure
Roundup
Life.
Doesn't cause cancer. Or, no, we looked at this and there were zero particulates. Nestle is a clean company.
After the scientist that had zero interest in the outcome
this,
says there's 10,000.
The average, listen to this. Okay, Nestle has 10,390 plastic particles in their drinking water, okay, per liter. Now, the average per liter is, take a guess, right at 300. If you take all of them, and as you point out, Pellegrini was 74.
And we did a story a while ago that Nestle was the one that was stealing the water
stealing
out of the California. So they're getting the water for free, and they can't even make sure
well,
it's clean.
Well, tell them that story.
That was the water that they had some lease that they were extracting water out of.
Stealing
one of the
water. They were stealing water.
And they had, the ability per the lease to extract a certain amount of gallons.
Right.
And it was this big.
But the lease was 50.
But after like 50 years that it would have been expired and they'd been taking out water, they were taking out several thousand percent more.
Paying nothing,
and it had no lease and anything else, and then come to find out they can't even make sure the water's clean.
So while California is burning to the ground because they're having, problems.
Drought issues.
Huge drought issues. You've got the company, Nestle, pumping water out of their aquifer for free in the millions and millions of gallons. Then they take that water and they put it in a bottle. Okay, now when they put it in the bottle, it has 10,390 pieces of plastic in it.
And they ship it up to Michigan, Flint, Michigan, and sell it to them at an exorbitant rate because they can't drink out of the taps.
Big up charge for if you're in Flint.
Pure life.
You gotta love corporate America.